Hi friends, welcome back to this ReactJS Advanced Concept series. In the last video, I have explained about useMemoHo. In this video, I'm going to talk about useReducer in depth. Let's start. useReducer is a React hook used for managing state logic. It's an alternative to useState, particularly when the state logic is complex or depends on previous states. In other words, we can say it's particularly useful when we have state that needs to be updated based on different actions, or when we want to centralize state management logic. The key benefits of using useReducer are centralized state management, complex state updates, and code readability. Instead of going into theory, let me use an example to explain the need for useReducer hook. In this application, I have a count state. I have few buttons to increment, decrement, reset it to 0, and set it to a specific number. In this case, I'm setting it to 10. Also, I'm maintaining another state called history to track all my values and showing them here. For this use case, if I use useState, I need to create two separate states and then four different functions for four different actions, and I need to call the respective functions in each button. But I can do one thing. I can combine these two into a single state so that instead of setting two separate states, I can do it using a single setState function. Even in this, I need to have four different functions for these four actions. This will become more complex when we have more actions. Let me show you how we can use useReducer to solve this difficulty. First, let me create an initial state object and have these here. Okay, now let me create a reducer function. Reducer function is a function that determines the new state based on the current state and an action. So this reducer function accepts two arguments, current state and action. And this function should return the updated state based on the action. For that, let me use switch case. When the action type is going to be increment, let me return this. Similarly, let me do this for the other actions. Here we have value. Let's get this from the action. Let's also return the original state inside default section. Ideally, this is not needed, but let it be. Okay. Now let's get into the function. Here, like useState, let's use the destructuring syntax. In useState, we have setState function. Here we have dispatch function. And in useReducer, we need to pass the reducer and initial state. Finally, for each button, we need to call the dispatch function. We have to pass the respective action type. So when any of these buttons is clicked, the respective action will be dispatched and the reducer function returns the updated state based on the action. And for this, we need to pass the value also, because we need this value here. Okay, let's test it once. Everything is working like before, but this time, our logic is maintained inside a single reducer function. Our code is clean now and easy to maintain. Hope you understood the need for useReducer. Okay, let's move to the next concept, Lacy initialization. I have explained the same concept in my useState in-depth video. Let's see how we can achieve this using useReducer. In this application, I have a button to increase the count. But the problem is the initial state of this count is getting derived using a complex calculation. To simulate that, I'm looping this initial value for more number of times and returning the result. I have also placed some console logs to find out when this calculation is getting started and when it is getting ended. And we can see we are calculating the initial state by calling this function and passing that to useReducer. And so if I refresh the application, we can see it is taking some time to calculate the initial value, and once it is done, the state is getting changed. Also, if I click this again, we can see again it is taking some time to render the new value. Every time this complex calculation function is getting called. Now let me change this code to use lazy initialization. It is very simple. We just need to pass the initial value as the second argument and the complex calculation function as the third argument. That's it. Now if I refresh, we can see the initial calculation is taking the same amount of time. But once it is calculated, we can see the subsequent button click is not invoking the complex calculation function, and so it is fast. Okay. In use context in-depth video, I have explained how we can use useState along with context. Similarly, please note that useReducer can also be combined with useContext to manage global state. For example, something like this. This setup allows state and dispatch to be accessible throughout the component tree, enabling a centralized state management system. Okay, before we close, let me explain some best practices to be followed. Always, we should avoid side effects in reducers. That means reducers should be pure functions with no side effects like API calls, updating local storage, etc. We should not mutate the existing state directly. Instead, we should always return a new state object. Always ensure actions are structured consistently. That means all actions should have a type and an optional payload. We covered the useReducer hook in React and learned when and why it can be more effective than useState for managing complex state logic. Using useReducer helps you write cleaner, more structured code when managing complex state in React apps. That's all for today. I hope this video made it easy to understand and apply. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below with any questions or future topics you would like to see. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.